Hello friends, welcome to Techstudy Cell. In this video, we'll make a very useful IoT-based home automation project to control the appliances with Google Assistant, Amazon Alexa app, and you can also control the appliances manually with switches and IR remote. And in this project, after the power cut, Arduino can remember the previous state, so when the power comes back, the appliances will automatically turn on according to the previous state. And to make this project, you just need an Arduino UNO relay module, ESP01, IR receiver to control the relays with IR remote, some resistor and LEDs. And to control these relays manually, you can use switches or push button. So you don't need any custom design PCB to make this project. And during the video, I have shared the complete circuit diagram, source code. So after watching the complete video, you can easily make this project for your home. Now before going to the details, let me show you how this project works. First, let me control the appliances with the Amazon Alexa app. Alexa, turn on the room light.
Okay.
Now let me try the Google Assistant.
Hey Google.
Turn on the kitchen light.
Okay, turning on the kitchen light.
And you can also use the Google Home app. Let me turn on the night lamp from this Google Home app. And you can see the lamp turns on. And I can also use this IR remote to control the appliances. Now let me turn on the lamp one by one. And you can monitor the real-time feedback in the Google Home app. Now again, let me turn off all the lamps. Now I will control these appliances from the manual switch. And again, you can monitor the real-time feedback. Now I will turn off the Wi-Fi and show you how it works without internet. After turning off the Wi-Fi, you can see the LED turns off, which indicate now the ESP01 is not connected with the internet. So I can only control the appliances from the manual switch and from the IR remote. And I cannot monitor the real-time feedback as it is not connected with the internet. Now let me turn on the Wi-Fi again. After turning on the Wi-Fi, you can see the LED automatically turns on, which indicates now the ESP01 is connected with the Sinric. So I can control the lamps from the Google Home app. Now let me open the Amazon Alexa app. So you can control the appliances both from Google Home and Amazon Alexa app. So this is a very useful IoT project and I have used all the free tools. So without any further delay, let's get started. In this IoT project, when you asked Google Assistant to control the appliances, it sent the signal to Sinric server. Then ESP01 will receive the signal from the Sinric and it forward the same signal to Arduino through the serial communication. Then Arduino process that signal and accordingly turn on or off the relays and send the feedback to ESP01 again through the serial communication. Then ESP01 again send the feedback to Sinric server so that we can monitor the real-time feedback in the Google Home or Amazon Alexa app. You can find all the required components to make this project in the video description. And this is the complete circuit diagram of this project. If you use Arduino UNO, then you can skip this 3.17 voltage regulator. If you use the 3.3 volt pin to supply the ESP01, but if you use Arduino Nano, then you have to use this regulator. You can refer the circuit diagram and you can see these switches are connected across the digital pin and the ground pin. And if you use push button, then just you have to connect the push buttons or momentary switch across the digital pin and the ground pin instead of the switches. And these two resistors will act as a voltage divider to drop down the 5 volt logic level from Arduino to 3.3 volt for the ESP01. The circuit is very simple, you can easily make it, but still to make the circuit compact and give the project a professional look, I have designed a PCB for this project. So if you want to purchase the PCB, then download the GABA file from the video description and order it from the JLC PCB. You can order any custom design PCB from JLC PCB with three simple steps. First, upload the GABA file. Then select the parameter like quantity, PCB masking color. Then place the order. If you select faster delivery service, then you will get the PCB within a week. And as you can see, the quality of the PCB is very premium in this affordable price range. So you can always try JLC PCB for your any custom design PCB project. Now these are the components required for the PCB. After soldering all the components, the PCB will be look like this. Now before uploading the code, I have to configure the Sinric account. For that, I will use Sinric Pro, and you have to visit this page. I have mentioned the link in the description. Then click on sign up, and you have to mention all these details to create an account. I already have an account in Sinric Pro, so I will click on login and enter the credential and then click on login. This is the dashboard. First we'll go to rooms, and here I will add one room. You can give any name, but I am giving living room, and then click on save. So our room created. Then we'll go to devices. So here I am using the free version, so I can add maximum 3 devices. First we have to click on add devices, then give the name of the device. I am giving room light. Device type will be switch, and I will select the room as living room. Then I will click on next. Now if you want any notification related to that device, then you can turn it on. I don't need that notification, and again I will tap on next, and then I will click on save. Our device is created. In similar way, I will create the next 2 devices. So I have created these devices, and each device has a unique ID, you can see, which will be required in the code. Now these are the source code for this project. These 2 code are for the Arduino. This is the code for the ESP01. In the code name you can see ESP01 is written, and this is the code to get the hex code from any IR remote. Now you can download all this code from our website iotcircuithub.com. Just visit the article link given in the description. Then you can download the code from this button. With this PCB, I can easily program the ESP01. First, I have to place these 2 jumper at this place. Then I have to select the program mode with these switches. This will connect the GPIO0 and ground. Then I can connect the FDDI232 USB to serial interface board on this PCB. Now I can upload the code directly to ESP01. If you are not using the PCB, then please refer to this circuit to program the ESP01. And I have already made a tutorial video how to program the ESP01. You can get the link in the video description. Now this is the code for the ESP01. First, you have to download and install all these libraries. You can refer these links. Now in this code, first I have to enter the Wi-Fi name, then Wi-Fi password, then I have to enter the app key. For that, I have to visit the Sinric Pro account. Then I have to go to credential, and this is the app key. Let me click here to copy it. Then go to Arduino IDE and paste it here. Now I have to enter the app secret. Again I will go to Sinric Pro account, and this is the app secret. Again I will click here to copy it, and here I will paste it. After that I have to enter the device ID. For that let me go to the Sinric Pro account and then click on the device. So these are the device ID. As I am using free account, so I can create maximum 3 devices. So first let me copy the device ID one by one. So I will click here to copy the device ID, and here I have to paste it. Now if you purchase their paid plan, then you can create the 4th device and accordingly paste the device ID at this place. After doing all this, I can upload the code to ESP01. If you go through the code, you can easily understand how this code works. So to upload the code, first I have to go to tools, select the board as generic ESP8266 module, and select the proper port, then hit the upload button. After programming the ESP01, I will program the Atmega 328P microcontroller. For that I will remove the FDDI232, then place the jumper at this place to program the Atmega 328P microcontroller. So here you can see I placed the jumper here. Now I will exit from the programming mode for ESP01. Then I will connect the FTDI232 with the PCB again. Now I can program the Atmega 328P microcontroller directly from my laptop. These are the code for the Arduino Uno. Now I am going to use the code for the push button. In the code, first you have to install all these libraries. Then you have to update the hex code here. In my previous video, I have already explained how to get the hex code from any IR remote. You can get the link in the video description. Then here you can see I have added a function Wi-Fi control to get the data from the ESP01 through serial terminal and control the relays. So if you go through the code, you can easily understand, as here I'm going to upload this code to Atmega 328P microcontroller. So I have selected the Arduino Uno board and then select the proper port, then hit the upload button. Now I will quickly configure the Google Home app. Let me open the app. Then first I have to create the home. So I will tap on create new home. Give a name, say smart home. You can give any name. Then tap on continue. So you can also set the home address. Currently I am skipping this step. Now I will connect the Sinric Pro with the Google Home app. For that again I will tap on the plus icon and tap on the setup device. Now here I will tap on the works with Google, and here you have to search for Sinric Pro. So here you can see this is the Sinric Pro. I will tap on it. Now I have to log in to Sinric Pro account. Now go to the dashboard. So here you can see all the device added to Google Home app, and I can also control this device from the Google Home app. And you can see the first three relay turns on. Now I will configure the Amazon Alexa app. So let me open the Amazon Alexa app. Then I will tap on more and select skills and games. Here I have to add the Sinric Pro account. So I will search for Sinric Pro. Tap on the Sinric Pro. So you can see this is the Sinric Pro. I will tap here again. Now tap on enable to use. Then log in to Sinric Pro account. Now the Sinric Pro is successfully linked. So I will close it. Then I will tap on discover devices. You don't need any Echo Dot for this project. You just need to install the Amazon Alexa app. It may take some time. And during this time, make sure this yellow LED turns on, which indicate ESP01 is connected with the Sinric server. So you can see Alexa found three device. So let me go to the device tab. I will tap on device, and in the plug you will find this device. Again, let me try to control this from Alexa app, and you can see I can control this relays from the Amazon Alexa app. As you can see, I have connected this AC appliances with the PCB, and here you don't have to give separate DC 5 volt, as I have used high link AC to DC converter. So you can directly connect 220 volt here, and this is the IR receiver, and this is the Wi-Fi indicator, which indicate now the ESP01 is connected with the Sinric. And you can also use latch switch. So if you use latch switch, then you can connect the latch switch with these pins, but here I will use the push button. Now first let me control the appliances with the Google Home app. Now I will control the appliances with the IR remote. Now let me use the push button to control these appliances, and you can also connect the latch switch with this PCB to control the appliances manually. So this is a very useful project you can easily make for your home, and you can also support my work on Patreon. You will find a link in the description. And if you like this project, then please hit the like button and share it with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe for more such videos. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.